Emmanuel, the God with us who saves.
Nowadays, we live in very difficult times. And normally, when difficult times happen, we look for people whom to turn to. And we are not surprised that already, since time immemorial, there is someone whom we can rely on. We believe that the Mother of God, who is a human being like us, except that she had always been one with God, is also our mother by divine decree. And because of this, a mother always cares for her children. We are her children, even those who do not know it yet. And we will be surprised that the mother, we say, appears in different places, in different times, to different people. That will be the topic of our reflection in this series of Apparitions of Our Blessed Mother. We welcome you to this program, and we hope that you will join us in the spirit of love for God and love for our Holy Mother and love for the Church. You will join us in prayerful reflection of what the Holy Mother is doing to her children until now, out of fidelity to her their only begotten Son, Jesus, the only begotten Son of God. So hopefully, we will be together time and again to reflect on different events, different occasions where people believe that the Holy Mother has appeared to some people. And some of these apparitions are approved by the Church. Others are considered worthy of reflection and devotion. Other apparitions of the Blessed Mother may await reflection, but we will try to, or we will await approval, but we will try to learn from these interventions of the Holy Mother in the life of the Church and in the life of the world. Let us first ask ourselves, what are apparitions? When we talk of apparitions of the Blessed Mother, we know that she's a supernatural character. She was a human being 2,000 years ago, but gifted by God. And one of the signs of the success of God in achieving His plan, the Holy Mother is already sharing in God's glory, in the glory of her Son. That is one of the contents of our faith. Now, the Holy Mother, we consider her as a supernatural being. All of us are called to that kind of life already here on earth. We must have supernatural grace and supernatural existence. That means contact with God. God is one who wants to be with us. And in many ways, even in the past, He had also appeared to people. So even the Old Testament, to Moses, to the patriarchs, in different ways He would appear in human form or in voices, or in the case of, let's say, Moses, He appeared as a burning bush. Different ways. We call that sometimes theophany, the apparition of God. No? So it happened already in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, of course, the real and magnificent apparition of God is seen in Jesus Christ, who is the Son of God, became man. And Jesus Christ, in many ways, after the resurrection, appeared to some people, His disciples. Even in recent times, we hear people who claim that it's either the God the Father or Jesus Christ appearing as a human being, and the Blessed Mother and the saints appearing to them. So, apparitions or manifestations connect people with heavenly beings, angels or saints or divine God, and of course the Mother of God. Now, when we think of the Blessed Mother's apparition, even God's coming to visit His people, we think of visitation. One of the most beautiful scene in the Bible is when the Blessed Mother, after being visited by the angel Gabriel, knowing that her cousin, who was already advanced in age, but gifted by God to have a child in her old age. She was already 6 months expecting John the Baptist. And the Mother of God, she is the proof of the truth that God can do the impossible. So the Mother of God received for the first time the Word of God in her womb. Remember, as St. Bernard said, the Mother of God received first the Word of God in her heart, and then received Him in her womb and became a human being through her. As a proof of that, the angel told her, your cousin Elizabeth, in her old age, is already 6 months expecting a child. And so she went to the hill country of Judea, to the house of Zechariah, according to the Gospel of St. Luke. And the Blessed Mother traveled from Nazareth, where she met the angel, until Ein Karim. The house of Zechariah is found there, around 6 kilometers from Jerusalem. That is at that time when there were no automobiles. The only way of transportation is horse, carts, you know. So she must have traveled for maybe at least 2 days continuously. Probably she traveled 4 days, including resting. Anyway, the child in her womb, it was 4 days old, while the child in the womb of Saint Elizabeth was 6 months old in the womb, both of them in the womb. But when the Blessed Mother greeted her cousin Elizabeth, Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. That is the great miracle of the visitation. And you know, one of the most beautiful expressions in the Gospel was said by Elizabeth. How is this that the mother of my Lord has come to me? She recognized that the one who came to visit her is the mother of the Lord, because at the moment that she heard the voice of Mary, the child in her womb leapt for joy. Why? Because the child encountered God, the Son of God Himself, whom He was destined to prepare the way for. Now, that is a beautiful saying that has very, very deep meaning for our discussion. How is it? How worthy we are? We don't deserve, and yet we are visited by the Mother of the Lord. The Blessed Mother, probably when she came to visit Elizabeth, had in mind to help her cousin in the 3 months before she would give birth to Saint John the Baptist. But God has a different purpose. Jesus started His work of saving the world whilst He was still in the womb of His mother. We should even say that the plan to save humanity and the whole world is planned by God even before everything existed, or even before Mary was conceived immaculate in the womb of her mother Anna. So Jesus was already desiring and very active to bring God's blessing to people, and one of the first people she brought blessing to, besides His own mother, who is always blessed anyway, and of course the foster father, was Elizabeth and the child in the womb. And that is the reason for the apparitions. We must not look at the apparitions as something sensational, something a privilege for a few. The Lord God Himself wants to be with us. He visits us again and again. And the Mother of God, so close to God, united to God, has the same purpose. Another very important biblical passage, especially concerning the Blessed Mother, is of course the crucifixion. While on the cross, Jesus hanging on the cross, when he saw his mother and John, the beloved disciple, it is Saint John who said the beloved disciple, he never mentioned his name. He said to the mother first, "Woman, behold your son." Remember that he called his mother woman because that is the title already known in the book of Genesis. God told the devil in the form of serpent, "I will put enmity between you and the woman, your seed and her seed. She will crush your head," or "it," the seed will crush your head. Both of them, the woman and the child, will crush the head of the evil one. That's why Jesus used the name woman. For us, it was disrespectful to calling your mother woman. But no, that was a biblical, a very important expression. The woman is the sign of salvation. So, he said, "Woman, behold your son." And then to the beloved disciple, and we will not forget, Saint John represents all of us. We must believe we are the beloved disciples. Jesus telling us at that most important moment of his life when he was fulfilling the plan of the Father, because the plan of the Father was to unite us to himself. And the way to our union with God is the passion, death, and resurrection of Christ. So that death was life-giving to the whole world and to all humanity. And the woman, the mother, is involved very closely with that. So we have to accept her as mother. And really, the Mother of God, commanded by her own son, who is God, to whom she is most faithful, to whom she only lived because the whole life of the Blessed Mother was Jesus. The whole life of the Blessed Mother was dedicated, consecrated to God. But that included the desire of God, the desire of her son, that she would be the mother of all those who are called to be God's children. So if there is any reason for her being the mother of God and mother of us all, it is to bring us all to heaven. That's why she visits us. The image of her visiting from the very start, her cousin Elizabeth, is the sign that she's not going to waste any time. Visit her children. Now we live in difficult times. She knows very well, as a very good mother, how much we are in trouble and how much we need God and we need her. Oftentimes we don't realize that. That is the reason for the apparition. That's why when we think of apparitions, we must not only think of, "Oh, it is wonderful to see this most beautiful lady from heaven, and we are privileged that in this place, through these persons who see the Blessed Mother, we are privileged to be able to be close to her." It's not just a privilege. It is not just a wonderful thing. There is a purpose. We can give the summary of that purpose just as God decides that all of us be saved. That God is there willing always to come to our assistance. That God is our salvation. That without Him we can reach nowhere except damnation. We need God to become one with Him, which is His plan. So God visits us. And the one who is close to God, most especially the Blessed Mother, the saints who are already close to God, we know very well, the church recognizes many souls who have gone already to the next life. They are so close to God that they are God's messengers to us. They are angels All the men and women who are in heaven with God are messengers of God. Because you know, when you know what God is giving men, and some people do not realize that the gift of God is immense and so great, so wonderful, you will, really, if you love God, you will do something to bring people to the awareness of this great gift of God. And so, the Blessed Mother is the greatest of all the saints, the greatest among the angels, is Queen of Angels and Saints. She will visit us. And in these difficult times, they say that there are so many apparitions of the Blessed Mother in different places. Some are known, others are not known. Some are well documented, others not. Some are recognized by the church, others are maybe the church warns us that to be careful a little bit. But I personally believe that the Blessed Mother really visits us, whether we see her or not. But there will be other people who can really discern her presence, sometimes hear her voice, no? Be able to communicate with them in the heart and tell us what she is saying. Because the Blessed Mother will do everything in order to warn us that we need to change our lives. We need to pray. We need to be with Him, to believe in her Son. And we need to be like her, totally united to her Son and faithful to God. Just like she is, that's why she's Mother. Many saints all saints are devoted to the Blessed Mother. But many saints have said she is more Mother than Queen. Because we tend to admire her. Because she's so privileged. She's so powerful. But we forget that she is first of all Mother. And in our ordinary circumstances, she would be there. And she would like us to know that she cares for us. And she wants us to be like her. Always faithful to God, faithful to her Son, Jesus. No? So, the Blessed Mother comes, yeah. And again, also Jesus, time and again, would make apparition to some people. God Himself, they come, they manifest themselves. The heavenly beings are there to warn us. Sometimes it is Saint John, Saint Joseph, the baby Jesus, sometimes infant Jesus, appearing to saints or would-be saints, even to sinners. No? God is not limited by us. You know, some of us would say, I would not believe in that person because he's a great sinner. He is not worthy of being visited by God. God has His own mind. We cannot limit His mind. And many times, He also visits sinners. There are atheists who came to know God, converted by God Himself, or the Blessed Mother. All this, the intention is to bring us or anyone else, even sinners, even non-believers. You know, one of the apparitions so-called recently of the Holy Mother, I think it's called Kaitum, somewhere in Egypt. I had been there once also in Egypt. And she appeared to many people. They saw her several times on top of an Orthodox church. Orthodox church. You know, Orthodox are not united to us Catholics. But now, because I think it's one of the things that Blessed Mother is achieving in making visits to everyone, including Protestants who may be attacking her, who may be attacking our attachment to her. Sometimes she appears to Protestants. What is the purpose? To tell them that she's indeed the Mother of God, that she has one purpose in loving us and caring for us, to bring us all to Jesus, to unite us to Jesus. She wants to see Jesus in us. She wants to see us in Jesus. That is what she does. That's why if we really, you know, we can tell our non-Catholic brethren, because we are happy that they recognize how attached we are to the Blessed Mother. Sometimes they criticize us for being over-attached, saying that we are adoring the Blessed Mother, which is not true. We adore only God, but we pay homage to her because she is especially loved by God. And she is an instrument of God to make us God's children. And she is Mother of Jesus, So she also, according to Jesus' desire and the desire of the Father, that she is also the mother of all of us who should become God's children. We can tell them, you know how we revere her because God Himself honors her. Because she is so pleasing to God. Because she did everything that God wants to do. That is her fiat. Be it done to me according to your will. She is the great doer of God's will. And she is a model for us. And saints, as I have said, no, wants us, all of us, and follow them in really making our life similar and patterned after the Blessed Mother. Apparitions are that. The Blessed Mother reminds us that we must be faithful to God. Of course, in apparitions, there are healings. Why are there healings in apparitions? Because it is God who comes through the Blessed Mother or through the saints. No? And healing is part of saving. Actually, it is a very small part of saving. Because the first and greatest healing, and Jesus Christ showed that in the Gospel, what He always tells the people whom He is about to heal, your faith has made you whole. So the first thing for a sick person, all of us sick persons nowadays, especially of COVID, no? But the first thing a sick person should do is make a profession of faith. Be reconciled to God. That's why you know many of the sick persons, the anointing of the sick is for that. Huh? Many of the sick persons get well because first of all, they have peace within them because they're reconciled with God. Many of our sickness are due to our personal sins. Not only personal, also our sins that, you know, some of the children are suffering sickness because of the sins of their fathers. For if your father is not a good father, he, instead of feeding you, he drinks, no? You will go hungry, you will become sick, while your father is also becoming sick because of his vices. So the sins of our parents cause us sickness. But the truth is, sickness is our inability to live a life of completeness because of our enmity or lack of harmony with our environment. We have colds when the temperature changes. So there is no harmony between us, human beings, and nature. But that harmony was disrupted because of our lack of harmony with God. Because we are not God's children. Because we don't recognize Him. So when we reconcile ourselves with God, we also become more amiable, and we understand more, we are more forgiving towards other people. So that is again another result of sin, the sickness of our society. The wars, the bitterness, the anger, the hostility against one another. Reconciliation with God brings reconciliation with fellow human beings. The result also of our sinfulness is we don't trust ourselves. St. Paul said that very clearly. What I do is what I should not do. What I should do, I do not do. That means there is a dichotomy in our person. The person whom we should be, good one, and the person that we are, always defective. There must be harmony. And you know, holiness, someone said, is wholeness, integrity. When we are one, we are not divided within ourselves, we are integral, we are whole. And that holiness is wholeness. Our physical existence is subservient, obedient to our spiritual calling. The spiritual calling is to be with God, to be pure, to be good, to be always pleasing to God and to people. Our bodily, our fleshly existence seem to be selfish, always tending towards self-centeredness, neglecting other people. If that physical existence, our human life, is united and integrated with our spiritual existence, our union with God, even our self will be reconciled with ourself. And then the last, I said, the least in the healing work of God is healing our physical illnesses, because that is the last bad result of our enmity to God, which cannot be solved unless the other three are there. What are the other three? Reconciliation with God, reconciliation with other people, reconciliation with ourselves. Then we can be more in harmony with creation. So we see that healing, and usually you see water, you know, where there is apparition of the Blessed Mother, we have water. And water is the number one healer in our world, because it cleanses unless you pollute the water. But the water intended by God, especially when it is blessed by Christ, holy water is that. You can drink holy water. I have here sometimes what I call mediatrix water. I put it always on the side of Our Lady of Mediatrix, pray at night and during the day. Also with prayer, belief in the power of the Blessed Mother with God, we drink the mediatrix water. It cures. No? Because water is almost the whole world. The great part of our world, even the greater part of our being, is water. So the water comes out often in places where so-called apparition takes place. Because curing sickness is the immediate sign of the presence of God. God wants us to be whole. God wants us to be healthy. God gives us the whole world, all the plants, all the food, and the air around us, meant to be healthy. If our environment is causing us sickness, it is because maybe of industry which neglects the welfare of the great majority. So you pollute the air, and then you destroy the trees, and then you kill the animals. The animals are bearers of God's gifts, no? But we destroy them, and in the end we also destroy ourselves, no? So God created everything in harmony for our good. So He heals. He heals through the creatures that around us. That's why whenever the Blessed Mother appears, or even God appears, or all of them, sometimes they appear together, no? Like in Fatima, the last days of the apparition, Saint Joseph was there, the child Jesus was there. God is surely there, even when He is not visible. God is always everywhere. God, where God is present, there is salvation. And the Blessed Mother is the image of human being like you and me, in whom God is fully present, and who is fully present in God. That's why she is our mother, she is our model, she is the best instrument of God to bring us what is good. And she reminds us again and again. And that is the meaning of apparitions. That is the meaning of theophanies. Even when it is the Blessed Mother who appears, she appears in the name of God. The angel appears, she appears in the name of God. No? Saint Joseph appears, he always brings God with him. If the devil appears, God is not with him. He is against God. And you better be careful, because sometimes the devil appears to us in order to disturb us, in order to make us afraid, and in order to bring us away from God. So let us continue to follow these reflections. I hope that all of you will like this being with our Blessed Mother, understanding why she comes to us again and again, and we must be able to say with Saint Elizabeth, "Who am I that I should be visited by the Mother of the Lord?" And at this point, I can already tell you, the Blessed Mother visits us again and again. Sometimes we don't know it. We better know it. Even if we don't see her, she is there caring for us, loving us. And the truth is, because she is there, our God, the Father, the Holy Spirit, whom she is so united to, that's why she is spouse of the Holy Spirit, and Jesus, her Son, they are all with us. The Holy Mother is the most beautiful expression of the presence of God among us. May Almighty God bless you all. May He protect you through the help of our Blessed Mother. and our friends in heaven, the angel saints. And I bless you in their name, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.